Yeah, I should go out to the wheels there for the car. Wonder what will fit. Talk about dedication.
time to hand over to the two chaps up over here.
Clip two, straight away from clip.
Oh my gosh.
This weekend in his Link ECU, LDC Electrics, CM Wheels, Euro M Sport, Sylvia S15, 2JZ underneath the bonnet, 700 brake horsepower. This guy has been at it longer than drifting has been in existence. Ready to put on a show here at Punchestown this weekend. Just getting the nose of that S15 into that out, into that end of the zone, and takes it again. Shaping up to be a good run here. Big pole up to the final wall, but shuts it down at the just at the very last moment. Now can he find the inner? He's going to be done, he certainly can, and he tucks it in nicely. Looking very comfortable. And this guy is on the ball.
What a run from Lee.
performance off.
Yeah, really strong performance. A hard man to motivate in qualifying, and he really only ups his game when it comes to battles in the last two.
Just down the front right there as he cuts the nose and it hits really deep inside that pivot point. Pulled up deep onto the wall, deep onto the wall.
On his first run. Where is that leading? Well, down the order, outside that top 32. Can he find some
scores out there, and they're set to get bigger as we move through qualifying.
You got to remember, board S15, snatched RP underneath the bonnet of this S15. Whatsoever, just hammers the limiter as he finishes up the run there, clouds out the arena here in Punchestown, and McKeever heads back to the grid. Maverick, Will Barker score enough to get himself into the show, though, Ian? I think he may have done enough.
I think it might
give Martin the best show possible. We know the drivability is there.
Oh, yeah.
This is where it matters. Comes hunting for the inner kick, and he comes down to the judging tower. Cross flush, a little bit wide, and also that Jason X. Certainly get in the car. I think that's a tidy run for Martin, and maybe not the best run he's ever got.
Point. It wasn't as much, it didn't have as much impact, and
slams through the gears as he comes through that short little run up. As he goes by the grandstand, that's going to hurt the score. He now looks to tidy it up to the second half of the run. Connecting those pits as he brings it towards the wall. Can he get the rear end? Judges thought.
Yeah,
it's all about a bit of 40.
Comes off the line, big opposite flick for Joe Weiss right there as he gets it up.
Oh, he's very wide, but he stays in it right now.
Appreciation.
Right. I think you said it.
Move that wall back and get that repaired so we can carry on with qualifying. Not many more drivers to go, Eddie, before we round out qualifying here at round 4 of the Drift Games Extreme Championship. And don't forget, the 21st and 22nd, in 4 weeks' time, we have the final Jackfest at Mondello Park, where we will see the best of Europe come to town. We'll see the Drift Masters European Championship finish off the championship right there at Mondello Park alongside Jackfest and alongside this championship. Now. Two championships, Eddie.
Gentlemen, sorry for the delay. Of course, our track team now just putting the final touches to the wall after the impact, which saw Shane Rogers put the rear end quite deep into that outer zone.
Very deep. Yeah,
and just unset those barriers. A 0 for him on that second run, but an 8-4 on the first run. Sees him comfortably into that top 32. Technical midsection there. Across off the line. It looked as though it was about to fall apart there from D-Man.
Transition while too early, doesn't get on that right line. He has to pick up that front pivot point now. Bad Moore got work to be done. He gets in that off the ball. Bad Moore now transitions into the
final zone. You're a blue on the back, you're right.
Yeah.
Manages to keep the
camera,
takes it right over the wall. Falvey hunts the short area. Feeling hungry this afternoon as he calls for that inside give himself. Can he take it into the wall? Absolutely. Showing no sign of fear of taking to the wall on the grandstand. Falvey now switches it back for the final time.
Thank you.
get there for the next one.
There's nothing in this for these two guys. This is going to be a very close match. As you can see, he can't put the hallmarks on the back bumper of Kevin Quinn as he makes a huge dive in the
opens the door for Coleman to make a move down the inside, and a big dive now from Coleman as they come towards the judging tower, back up towards the ground, and the gap starts to open up again as Coleman now looks to try and draw back that disadvantage. They go, I think, because I can't exactly see them with all the smoke.
Thank you. see we're on.
Send these boys into that first corner. What happens next? We can't.
Jump up onto the side of kind of Jack Shanahan's GT86, and you can see he kept that proximity all the way through. Straightens, Shanahan backs out of it, keeps on the door though, keeps that proximity as they transition again. Bam!